This is Spanish 3, Unit 2, Part 1. Make sure to get your Spanish 3 textbook either at your school site or get a download from Omega and get the PDF so that you can follow along and complete your work as well. For Vocabulario en Contexto, to start with Unit 2, we're at page 68, página 68. Los estudiantes de la Escuela Simón Bolívar de Caracas, Venezuela, querían decorar la cafetería de su escuela. Para esto, decidieron pintar un mural en una pared de la cafetería. Antes de comenzar a pintar, los estudiantes se reunieron en el taller de arte para planear lo que querían hacer. So, make sure you're paying special attention to the letters in bold, the words in bold blue. These are words that you'll be responsible for. Everything else you should understand. Students from the Simón Bolívar School in Caracas, Venezuela, wanted to decorate the cafeteria, their school cafeteria. To do that, for that purpose, they decided, decidieron pintar, to paint un mural, a mural, en una pared de la cafetería, in a wall of the cafeteria. Antes de comenzar, before beginning painting, before they started to paint, los estudiantes se reunieron. The students met together in a taller de arte, in the art workshop, para planear lo que querían hacer, to plan what they were, what they wanted to do. Okay, so you have some vocabulary here. La naturaleza muerta, this still life. You have el mural, the mural. Ella está sentada, she's seated. Él está parado, he's standing up. El pincel, you have a paintbrush. El pincel, la paleta is a palette. Los estudiantes miraron muchas obras de arte de diferentes pintores y finalmente escogieron una del pintor catalán Joan Miró para usarla en el mural. Joan Miró fue un artista famoso del siglo XX. Okay, so the students looked at many obras de arte, many works of art, de diferentes pintores, the different painters, y finally, escogieron una del pintor catalán. Escogieron one from the Catalan painter, Joan Miró. Pintor catalán, it's his province in northern Spain. And they're going to use it in the mural. Joan Miró fue un artista famoso del siglo XX. He was a famous artist from the 20th century. Siglo means century. Okay. And then the next page you have, estas son algunas de las obras de Miró que los estudiantes miraron cuando estaban buscando un cuadro para su mural. So these are some of the works that, some of Miró's works that the students looked at when they were looking, when they were searching for a painting for their mural. Número uno. Cuando era joven, Miró pintaba con un estilo realista, como podemos ver en el paisaje La Granja de 1922. En este paisaje se ve en primer plano un árbol entre una casa y un establo. Al fondo del cuadro vemos el cielo y la luna. So, talking about the painting, La Granja. Cuando era joven, when he was young, Miró painted with a realist style. Como podemos ver, as we can see, en el paisaje, La Granja, in the the landscape, paisaje, la granja, a farm, de 1922. En este paisaje, se ve means you can see it. It can be seen. En primer plano is the foreground in a painting. Un árbol entre una casa y un establo. Al fondo, fondo is background. Al fondo del cuadro vemos el cielo y la luna, the sky and the moon. Número dos, en esta pintura de 1919, el joven Miró hizo su propio retrato, es decir, pintó su autorretrato. So, the young Miró did his own portrait, hizo su propio retrato, he made his own portrait, es decir, that is to say, pintó su autorretrato, he painted his self-portrait. So, la pintura, paint, el autorretrato. Autorretrato es the self-portrait. Más tarde, el estilo de Miró se vuelve mucho menos realista, como se ve en este interior holandés de 1928. Más tarde, later on, the style of Miró, or Miró's style, se vuelve, it becomes, se vuelve mucho menos realista. So it becomes very less, much less realistic, realist. Como se ve, as you can see, right? Como se ve, as is seen in este interior holandés. So as you see, this painting is less more, as much less realist. Número cuatro, cuando ya era un artista famoso, Miró comenzó su obra de escultor. Esta escultura es abstracta, no vemos claramente lo que representa, pero sus colores vivos expresan sentimiento de alegría. So when he was already a famous artist, Miró began his work as a sculptor, escultor. This sculpture is abstract. I'm talking about this one right here. It's an abstract sculpture. We don't clearly see what it represents. Pero sus colores vivos, its bright colors, express feelings of happiness, sentimientos de alegría. We have entrevista con Dina Burstyn. Entrevista is an interview. Dina Burstyn es una escultora que nació en Mendoza, Argentina, y vive en Nueva York. Escribe poesía, cuentos y trabaja la cerámica para hacer murales y esculturas en distintos lugares de la ciudad. So, Dina Burstyn is a a female sculptor who was born in Mendoza, Argentina, and lives in New York. She writes poetry and stories and works on ceramics. She works with ceramics to make murals and sculptures in different places of the city. ¿Qué material prefiere para expresarse? What material does she prefer to express herself? Principalmente barro. Pero también me gusta escribir y pintar. So, mostly, principalmente, principally, el barro, clay. Pero también me gusta escribir y pintar. ¿Qué artista la inspiró? What artist inspired you? Mi mayor fuente de inspiración fue mi tía Fanny. La fuente de inspiración is a source of inspiration. Ella pintaba y tenía obras de cerámica en su casa. So she painted and had ceramic works in her house. Influyó mucho en mí y empecé a moldear. She had a big influence in me. And I began to mold the clay, right? A moldear. A los 5 años yo llevaba siempre un poco de plastilina en los bolsillos, right? When I was 5, was already taking with me, always had with me a little bit of modeling clay in my pockets. ¿De qué está hecha esta escultura? What is this sculpture made of? Lady Dreams está hecha de barro. It's made of clay. ¿Qué representa la figura de Lady Dreams? What does the figure of Lady Dreams represent? Es una suma de las imágenes de mis sueños. También dice otras ladies. It's to say sum or a collection. It's like a sum total of images from my dreams, de mis sueños. También dice otras ladies. ¿Por qué escogió el tema de las ladies? Why'd you choose the subject of las ladies, the theme? Porque siempre me interesaron los mitos y pensé que necesitaba crear nuevos mitos. Entonces decidí crear mi propia mitología. So she chooses these ladies because they always interested the myths. Myths always interested her, and I thought it was I needed to make to create new myths. So I decided to create my own mythology. Artistas latinoamericanos. Durante el siglo XX, América Latina tuvo numerosos artistas que a través de sus diferentes estilos expresaron en sus obras la rica cultura de sus países. So during the 20th century, Latin America had numerous artists that, a través de sus diferentes estilos, through their different styles, expressed the rich culture of their countries in their works. Número uno, el pintor cubano Carlos Enríquez vivió en París en los años 20 y recibió la influencia del movimiento surrealista. Sus paisajes muestran la naturaleza y la luz intensa de los países del Caribe. So the Cuban painter Carlos Enríquez lived in Paris in the 20s. Los años 20 means in the 20s, like the 1920s, and received the influence of the surrealist movement. He was influenced by the surrealist movement. Sus paisajes, his landscapes show nature and intense light in the Caribbean countries. Número dos, el movimiento muralista mexicano muestra un país en el que se mezclan la cultura indígena y la española. So the muralist movement, the Mexican muralist movement, shows a country in which the culture, the indigenous culture, the Indian culture, and Spanish culture mix. Número tres. El pintor ecuatoriano Oswaldo Gallasamín mostró en su obra la cultura de los indígenas de América Latina y cómo vivían muchos de ellos. The Ecuadorian painter Oswaldo Gallasamín showed in his work the culture of the Indians, of the indigenous people of Latin America, and how many of them lived. Okay, then you have a vocabulario en uso, some practice. We'll also look at the grammar for this unit, for this part of the unit. Pretérito e imperfecto. Make sure you look at the preter and imperfect in la página 76. When speaking about the past, you can use either the preter or the imperfect, depending on the sentence and the meaning you wish to convey. Compare. Este fin de semana tomé una clase de cerámica. Cuando era niño, tomaba clases de escultura. Right? This weekend, I took a class on ceramics. And when I was a child, I took sculpture classes. So you can see this one thing is a habitual thing that happened over and over again, right? It's habitual. And in the first sentence, we had something that just happened over the weekend. So it's a completed action. That's called the preterite, tomé, something like tomé. Use the preterite to tell about past actions that happened and are complete. El sábado, la clase empezó a las 10 de la mañana. On Saturday, the class started at 10 in the morning. But use the imperfect to tell about habitual actions in the past. Cuando era niño, las clases empezaban a las 5 de la tarde. When I was a child, classes began or school began at 5 in the afternoon. you can see how it's different, talked about the day by day, right? The classes began. But here, class began at 10. It was on Saturday, and it's over with. Use a predicate to give a sequence of actions in the past. Cuando llegamos, la profesora sacó su pintura y sus pinceles y empezó a pintar. Okay? When we arrived, the teacher took out her paint and paintbrushes and began painting. Use the imperfect to give background details, such as time, location, weather, mood, age, and physical and mental descriptions. Eran las dos de la tarde. It was 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Estábamos en el parque. We were at the park. Era un día de otoño. It was an autumn day. Todos estábamos muy contentos. We were all very happy. Use the preterite and imperfect together when the action interrupts another that has taken place in the past. Estábamos en el taller cuando entró el profesor. We were in the workshop when the teacher arrived, when the teacher entered or came in. Use the imperfect when two or more actions are taking place simultaneously in the past. Mientras los niños pintaban, el profesor observaba las pinturas, right? As the children painted, the teacher observed the paints. Next, we have estar with participio. Many adjectives in Spanish are actually past participles of verbs. Recall that to form a past participle, you add ado for AR verbs and ido to ER, IR verbs. So decorar, we have decorado, decorated. Conocer, to know, becomes conocido, known. And preferir is preferido, preferred. So these are used as adjectives, but they're actually past participles of verbs. The past participle is frequently used with estar to describe conditions that are a result of a previous action. In those cases, the past participle agrees with the subject and gender and number. El pintor está sentado. Right? The painter is seated. Las paredes estaban pintadas. The walls were painted. Recall, the number of cases in which the past participle is irregular is very important to make sure you look at this list closely to review those words that have that weird, what we call diving form, the form that after estar or after haber, abierto, puesto for poner, decir becomes dicho. And it's relative. We have hacer is hecho. Resolver becomes resuelto. Escribir, escrito. Romper, roto. Ver, visto. Morir becomes muerto. And volver becomes vuelto. And that wraps up your vocabulary and grammar for the first part of Spanish 3. Gracias.